रेडी नाउ?
यस सर।
हाँ, वेरी स्टॉप इट सी। Stop हाँ, वेरी स्टॉप इट। कैल्शियम
कैल्शियम
कार्बोनेट
कार्बोनेट यूजेस
डिग्रेडेशन एंड
प्रॉपर्टीज
डिकम्पोजिशन एंड डिस्कस व्हाट यूजेस
यूज।
यूजेस ऑफ कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट। Right. This building consists of buildings, the form of marble, the form of marble. Even the marble is actually calcium carbonate. Granite or marble is actually calcium carbonate. It's the marble is actually more 5% of this particular calcium carbonate thing. So even the consists of building in the form of marble. Even the place of calcium oxide. This is based on calcium oxide and calcium hydroxide. This is the calcium oxide and calcium hydroxide. Which is based on good quality of paper. Based on high quality, good quality of paper also we apply this particular calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate goes in making a good quality of paper. It's a very important component of chewing gums. Whatever your chewing gums you chew on, the putting the chewing gums, the main component is your calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate is the main. The component in the chewing gums. We use it in toothpaste. We use it in toothpaste as a abrasive polishing material. Mild abrasive. We use it in toothpaste. The mild abrasive, mild polishing material. Mild abrasive. Mild abrasive. Yes. We also use the raw material. The manufacture of cement. The manufacture of cement. Main raw material for calcium carbonate. Main raw material for calcium carbonate. And even in the manufacture of sodium carbonate, even in the manufacture of sodium carbonate, by solvent process, also main one of the main raw material got calcium carbonate. Like this, calcium carbonate uses, come on. Using the construction of buildings in the form of marble. Using the construction of buildings in the form of marble. The form of marble. Marble. Next. During the preparation of calcium oxide and calcium hydroxide. Calcium oxide and calcium hydroxide. Calcium oxide and calcium hydroxide. Next, with the finish now, good quality of paper. Good quality of paper. Good quality of paper. One of the important component in chewing gums. One of the important component in chewing gums. Chewing gums. Use it in toothpaste. Use it in toothpaste as mild abrasive. Mild abrasive. Mild abrasive. It is very important raw material. Important raw material. Raw material. The manufacture of cement. The manufacture of cement, and also the manufacture of and also the manufacture of sodium carbonate by solvay process. Solvay process, right? The difference between lime water and milk of wine. Lime water and milk of wine. This question I put in the recent NEET examination. Very careful. What is lime water? Yashraj, what is lime water? Janavi? Hello?
Sir, aqueous solution of CaOH taken twice.
CaOH aqueous solution. What is the milk of wine? What is milk of wine? There is confusion. This question appeared in the recent last year exam. See. Write down. Calcium hydroxide less water allowed to steady for some time. Sometimes when calcium hydroxide settles to the water, this is what I'm writing is suspension of calcium hydroxide in water. Suspension of calcium hydroxide in water. This is actually milk of wine, which is remaining and insoluble in the bottom. Milk of wine. Composition is same. Milk of wine. This is milk of wine. This is on filtration again. Solution of getting. This is actually separate. Solution of getting. Solution. This is what is a lime water. This is lime water. The soluble part of calcium hydroxide in water is lime water. Insoluble part which suspended is water, milk of wine. So I am giving for this particular picture with that, most of the students concludes. This is, here I am showing you the ball. Take this also. This is solution, whatever it is. The suspension, whatever it is at the bottom. This is lime water, solution, lime water. This is milk of wine. Lime water and milk of wine. See, soluble part is lime water. Insoluble water is milk of plant. Very careful about this. Next, these are the calcium compounds. Next, calcium sulfate. Come on, next. Calcium sulfate. Calcium chloride and sulfuric acid, millimeter, but simply I am giving 1 meter. Available in 2 forms. Available in 2 forms. One, gypsum. One gypsum, alabaster, or satin spar, gypsum, alabaster, satin spar. It is calcium sulfate, which you walk. Next, cluster of pyrites. Cluster pyrites. Calcium sulfate. Now, H2O. Calcium sulfate. Twice H2O or 2PSO4 H2O. Next, gypsum, temperature, electron gypsum, many times question appeared on this. Last year also this question appeared in the this temperature, electron gypsum. Temperature, electron gypsum. He has got the rich so called monogenic exam. The mathematics is said monogenic. Thermal heating. Thermal heating. Only crystalline state changes. Crystalline state changes. SO4 to H2O. PS4 to H2O. Orthorhombic gypsum. Orthorhombic gypsum. Crystalline state is changing. Monoclinic, radial type, rhombus, orthorhombic gypsum. To just if this question is there in D-range, 375 degrees more than just 375 degrees. Up to 375 degrees minus 1.5 H2O, then we are getting plus of Paris. The SO4, half H2O. More than 375 degrees centigrade, minus half H2O, you know, again, CSO4 is known as burnt gypsum or dead burnt gypsum. Burnt. Burnt gypsum. Dead burnt gypsum. Burnt gypsum or dead burnt gypsum. If you are heating low, 11 degrees centigrade, calcium oxide, SO2, R4O2, you are always temperature effects. Very careful. Last year, this person appeared 375 off. Ashraj, completed.
Yes, sir.
All of you.
Yes, sir.
Harshita.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Next, do this up. Do this. The temperature will remember perfectly. Do this up, gypsum. Do the duration of loss of Paris. The plus of Paris, use it in cement to increase the setting time of the cement. Use it in cement, 2% are nearly used in cement. This increases the setting time of the cement. Next up, use it in making of blackboard chalks. Right. You then, one, preparation of plus of Paris. Plus of Paris. Next. You then instrument to increase. Cement to increase setting time of the cement. Increase the setting time of the cement. Setting time of the cement. Next. Using preparation of blackboard chalks. Blackboard chalks. Plaster of Paris. Plaster of Paris. Preparation. Internal heating dome. Internal heating dome. Properties. Properties. Yeah. White powder with water. With water, the addition of water is allowed to stand. And the addition of water allowed to stand for some time, it sets to what hard mass. It sets to what hard mass. During what? Setting of plaster of Paris. Setting of plaster of Paris. Now, in setting of plaster of Paris, many times questions appear, very careful about this. Setting of plaster of Paris is a exothermic process, remember. Exothermic process. So setting up plaster of Paris is exothermic process. Exothermic process. Yes. Second one. Absorbs water. One is exothermic process. Second is water. Absorbs water. When you are putting water, it takes water. Absorbs water. And the third one. While setting, expands a little. While setting, it expands a little. While setting, it expands a little. Because the plaster of Paris again reforms into, gypsum. Plaster of Paris with additional water, again it reforms into gypsum. Therefore, it sets to hard mass. What steps are they in setting up this particular plaster of Paris? I give it by equation. I give by showing a equation to you. Come on. White powder. Next. By adding water, followed by, stand for some time, sets to hard mass, sets to heart mass. Heart mass. This process is known as this process known as setting of cluster Paris. Setting of cluster Paris. Next slide. These are very important points. Next up. Next up. Setting of cluster Paris is setting of cluster Paris is A. Exothermic process. To the point of correct statement, wrong statement, be very careful. Exothermic process. Absorbs water. Only if you use as water. No, absorbs water. Absorbs water. C. On setting little expands. On setting little expands.
National Online Aptitude.
On setting little expands. On setting little expands. Due to deformation of plaster Paris into gypsum. Deformation of plaster Paris into gypsum. Now I'll show steps involved in setting of plaster Paris. Steps involved in setting of plaster Paris. Setting of plaster Paris. Yes, of course. Plus of our X. The second step. Second step. Number one of my job. Then CSFO. 2H2Walk. 2CSFO, 2H2Walk. This is now. Orthorhombic gypsum. Orthorhombic. Orthorhombic gypsum. Hardening step. Hardening. Hardening step. Two more water molecules are falling. Then two CDS of four, two H2O. Two CDS of four, two H2O. This is monoclinic, same thing, seven to ten, rhombic changing into monoclinic. Mono. Plane gypsum. Monoclane gypsum. Take it. Completed?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Now, it's monoclinic crystal bearing, small any type of monoclinic crystals. Monoclinic crystals bearing, small any type of monoclinic crystals like this. Therefore, these monoclinic crystals are intervening. These monoclinic crystals are intervening with each other and sets to about heart mass. This is what setting of cluster parades. Come on. Right or not? Not right? The needle type of monoclinic crystals, intervene with each other, intervene with each other, sets to a heart mass, uses of cluster parades. Look, for this particular cluster parades, it goes in construction of buildings for false roofing. Yes, your house also maybe there is false roofing, real roof. You know that false roofing we are making by using what some asbestos sheets. Inbuilt asbestos sheets, or we can use this cluster parades sheets also. Whatever the white sheets you are having in your top, that is what below the real roof, that is your false roofing we are making. That is actually made up of what cluster parades. So, doing the construction of buildings for false roofing. Next, during plastering the fractured parts of the body. During plastering the fractured body. We are putting what cement putty. It is not cement putty, it is simply plaster Paris putty. So it is used in plastering the fractured parts of the body. It also goes in making any apparatus A-type. You want a completely A-type close, then we are simply using this particular plaster Paris. As well, you can easily break it. You can put it after the hardening. If you want to break it, simply you can break it. Therefore, you need to use it in making the apparatus. Apparatus, anything you want to A-type, you can use this particular plaster Paris. Also, you use in the making of statues. Any statue or generally Vinayak idols, generally made up of this particular Vinayak idols, generally made up of this particular plaster of Paris. These are some important uses of our plaster of Paris. Come on. During the construction of buildings, for false roofing. Plastering the fractured parts of the body. Apparatus. Any glass apparatus in the laboratory, but a glass article you want to make it any type. So you need making the glass apparatus any type. right, it's completely different compounds. Then, biological importance of magnesium and calcium. Rather taken, general uses of beryllium, magnesium, calcium, very different. General use of beryllium, magnesium, calcium are taken, different uses. But they are also asking you biological importance. What is the importance of this particular use of that magnesium and calcium? Biological importance of magnesium and calcium. Biological importance. Importance of magnesium and calcium. Magnesium and calcium. Magnesium. Biological importance, not general uses. Biological use. General use is already given. This is biological use. Look here. Magnesium is there in our body and the living beings. In plants body, in our body also magnesium is there. So magnesium is a very important component in activating some of the enzymes. In activating some of the enzymes in our body and again plant body. You know, what are the most of the living beings? Most of the living beings, it activates phosphohydrolases, phosphotransferases. In these enzymes, the magnesium plus 2 is an important component, metal ion. It activates these enzymes, phosphotransferases, phosphohydrolases. Next. You know well, everybody knows, magnesium plus 2 is there in chlorophyll. Magnesium plus 2 are there in chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is very important for the plant life. Very important for plant life. It much more involves in what? Photosynthesis. No photosynthesis, no food. No food for you, no food for me. Therefore, chlorophyll is carrying what? Mg plus 2. Important metal cation. Come on. Magnesium plus 2 activates some of the enzymes like phosphohydrolases. Hydrolases, phosphotransferases. Hydrolases, transferases. Next, magnesium plus two is component metal ion in chlorophyll. Component metal ion in chlorophyll. In chlorophyll. Chlorophyll involves in photosynthesis. Come on, next, calcium. Biological importance of calcium, general importance already taken. Now, biological importance. Calcium is important component, metal, in our teeth and bones. In our teeth and bones, the bones form of calcium phosphate, Ca3, Ca4, Ca5. So, calcium is important metal ion, important metal in our eastern bonds in the form of calcium phosphate. This particular enamelon teeth, the shiny white surface, on our teeth, that is what enamel. Enamel teeth actually made up of enamel. Enamel is actually very hard substance. Very hardest substance, the enamel, it is actually made up of calcium. So hydroxyapatite. Enamel on teeth is actually hydroxyapatite. Hardest substance is what hydroxyapatite. This is what CA3, MO4, alkalivice, and CA, OH, alkalivice. This is what hydroxyapatite. Enamel on teeth, one of the hardest substance that is actually made up of calcium compound. That is what hydroxyapatite. Next step. As calcium is the important component that we are seeing in our teeth and bones, so our growth is actually based on skeletal growth only. Skeleton is growing, you are growing, I am growing. Therefore, so it is the important metal which regulates our body growth. That is the important component in the teeth and bones. Therefore, it is a very important component for regulating the growth. So it regulates that growth of our body. Therefore, children are generally given but milk and again this sparex, this and this, because they are actually high calcium containing compounds. So this regulates the growth of our body. And calcium regulates muscle contraction. This question happened very nice. Which of the following metal regulates muscle contraction? So muscle contraction is mainly monitored, mainly helped by this particular calcium. Calcium helps in muscle contraction. This question appeared many times there in the second. Next up. Heart is the muscular system. Muscle contraction is actually mainly dependent on calcium, is said. Therefore, the calcium regulates heart functions. Calcium regulates heart functions and heart rates. Heart functions and also heart rate. Next, calcium also involves critical diagram, neuromuscular irritability diagram. It is what Na plus K plus 2 ratio of concentration of Na plus K plus 2. What are the Ca plus 2, Md plus 2 diagram? So, Md plus 2 also involves in neuromuscular transmission. Good, come on, right. Calcium is an important component metal in teeth and bones. In the form of calcium phosphate. Enamel on teeth is made up of hydroxyapatite, the most hardest substance. Therefore, our teeth is very strong. Hydroxyapatite. CaOH taken twice. Next. Calcium is a component of teeth and bones. Therefore, helps in normal growth of our body. Calcium regulates muscle contraction. Next. Heart is a muscular system. Heart is a muscular system. Heart is a muscular system. Muscular system. Therefore, calcium regulates heart functions. Heart functions. Heart functions. Heart functions and heart rate. Heart to beat. Next, calcium involves in neuromuscular transmission. Neuromuscular transmission. Neuromuscular transmission. Next in this lesson, migration is the migration extraction is the very, very important migration extraction and all. Come on. Migration. Minerals of migration. Magnesite. What is magnesite? Magnesite. Magnesite. Arshita, what is the magnesite? Huh? Are you listening to me or not?
MgCO3.
Good. Magnesite. MgCO3 Epsom salt. Epsom salt. Epsom salt. Asbestos. Asbestos. Formula of asbestos still now appeared many times in the entrance exam. Be very careful. Formula of asbestos appeared many times in the entrance exams. This can be written like this. Calcium diffusion silicate. SiO3, PMD, SiO2. Remember, which metal is there, which metal is not there, and asbestos, like that. Questions are coming. Be very careful about this. From cornelite, extraction from cornelite. borderline. The current MDCL is a large quantity. From that MDCL, we are getting what MD, right? Steps involved. Steps. What you have to do is, you have to get what anhydrous MDCL from carnelite. Anhydrous MDCL from carnelite. Now, I give it a point to you. You remember or not, I don't know. Now, if carnelite are strong heating, what do you get? MgCl2 6H2O strong heating, what do you get at the end? Come on. Carnelite on heating, what do you get? Carnelite directly or heating, MgCl2 6H2O directly heating, what do you get?
MgO, sir. MgO.
Good, MgO. So how to get anhydrous MgCl2? Good, come on. Very good.
In presence of dry HCl.
Dry HCl.
How do we eat in presence of? Come on.
Dry HCl.
Very good. This point is very, very important. You have to remember this question at daily time that is exam. Very good. Come on. Right on. MgCl to 6H2O on direct heating. On direct heating undergoes hydrolysis due to its covalent character to 270 volt. Next slide. Next. To get anhydrous MgCl2, it is heated in presence of dry HCl gas. Dry HCl gas. Come on. MgCl2, H2O. Anything already, whatever you have given yesterday. Including pasta, or water molecule. MgCl2. If you are further heating, undergoes hydrolysis now, produce MgOH, Cl, basic magnesium chloride, plus HCl, plus H2O. Basic magnesium chloride. Magnesium chloride. So again, strong heating for heating MgO plus HCl. So you are not getting MgCl2. Therefore, second time I am giving, already 1 second I am giving, because very important. Now, heat impedance of by HCl. Dry HCl minus 6H2O minus 6H2O and nitrous. Step two. Electrolysis of anhydrous is here. Look here. The MCL is not highly ionic. It is having a more covalent character. They will not be directly electrolyzed. If they electrolyze, just 10-20% only is ionic. Therefore, so who is for the MCL? First, if the amount of NaCl, if the amount of KCl is direct, another little KCl regulate, still we have the NaCl plus KCl little amount. So, what are the advantages of hydration of NaCl and KCl? Be very careful about this question up here. Now, in particular, NaCl and KCl, first, between the melting point, first thing, between the melting point of the NaCl, so that you can conduct the electrolyte at lower temperature, first point. Second, increasing electrolytic nature. So, this NaCl KCl increases the electrolytic nature of NaCl too, so that it undergoes electrolysis. Prevents. So once MCl2, what are they? On heating, it may undergo hydrolysis. So that presence of NaCl and KCl prevents the hydrolysis of MCl2. Because of this particular three advantages, compulsory, with the amount of NaCl, KCl, added to MCl2 and subjected to electrolysis. Now, during electrolysis, it's very simple now. Think about it. During electrolysis, MgCl2, Mg plus 2, 2Cl minus. Now, this particular 2Cl minus at anode, 2Cl minus at anode converts into what? Chlorine gas. At cathode, what make it now? At cathode, 2 electrons, they will get what? Mg. This is the way we are getting MD from this particular corner light. Come on, step two. Electrolysis of anhydrous MgCl2, right? As, head on. As MgCl2 is not highly ionic, not a good electrolyte. Not a good electrolyte. Therefore, little amounts of NaCl and KCl are added. NaCl and KCl are added. It is subjected to electrolysis. Now, advantages of addition of NaCl and KCl. Advantages of addition of NaCl and KCl. A. Decrease the melting point of MgCl2. B. Increase the electrolytic nature of MgCl2. MgCl2. Next. Prevents hydrolysis of HCl2. Prevents the hydrolysis of HCl2 during electrolysis. During electrolysis. Electrolysis. Over. APC. Over. Next up. Next up. During electrolysis, the following reactions take place. During electrolysis, the following reactions take place. Right. Anode. Cathode. Completed.
Yes, sir. Completed.
Yes,
sir.
Right. Next. From magnesite. From magnesite. Next one. Yes. Decomposition of NbCO3 to get NbO. Electrolysis of NbO. Electrolysis of NbO. Now, 50 girls again, not highly ionic, no? Beryllium oxide, beryllium compounds are operating. Magnesium compounds are not highly ionic, more covalent in nature, not highly ionic. The MgO is also not a good electrolyte, not highly ionic. Therefore, little amounts of NaF, NaF plus MgF2 plus BaF2, little, not much, trace quantities of this particular NaF, MgF2, BaF2 are added to MgO and subjected to electrolysis. These are increasing the electrolytic nature of MgO. So that we really conduct electrolysis. During electrolysis, this is very simple now. NbO, electrolysis, Nb plus 2, 2 minus 2. 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2 minus 2, 2, 2 minus 2, then we do 2 to plus 4 electrons. Then this Md plus 2 electrons is your ready water, Mg. You see that water, anode, you see that water, cathode, right? MgO is not a good electrolyte. MgO is not a good electrolyte. To increase its electrolytic nature, to increase its electrolytic nature at melting point, little amounts of NaF MDF to BAF to added. NAF, MDF to BAF to added. Subjected to electrolysis. Subjected to electrolysis. Electrolysis. During that process, the following reaction takes place. During that process, the following reaction takes place. The following reaction takes place. Still few more methods are there to exhaust of magnesium. The risk class I know. The time is only up to 11:20. Right. The risk class I know remaining part. Still something being the extraction.